The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a statement about an example. And the example he gave was wa anna nabi Dawood alayhi salam. The Prophet Dawood alayhi salam kana ya'kulu min 'amali yadihi. He used to eat from the work of his own hand. If you know something about Dawood alayhi salam, he was one of the greatest rulers in the history of humanity. Allah Azza wa Jal himself said, "Inna ja'alnaka khalifatan fil ard." Ya Dawood, inna ja'alnaka khalifatan fil ard. Dawood, we are making you a khalifa in the land. From Jewish historical accounts, his empire was so big, there was no part of the known world that was not under his control. You could think of it as one of the greatest rulers humanity has ever experienced was Dawood alayhi salam. As a matter of fact, even when all of the children of Adam alayhi salam were shown to him, all of humanity was shown to Adam alayhi salam in the beginning, Dawood alayhi salam stuck out to him. He asked about Dawood alayhi salam, a special prophet of Allah. And what does Allah's Messenger say about this great king and ruler and prophet? He says he used to eat every meal that he ate based on the work he did with his own hand. What does the Quran describe about Dawood alayhi salam? Instead of describing to us the expanse of his government, how he used to render his armies, how many battles he fought, what descriptions do we find of Dawood alayhi salam? I'll just share one of them with you. He says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا. We gave Dawood alayhi salam a special favor that comes only from us. Allah says a special favor was given to Dawood alayhi salam. And a few of those things are uniquely miraculous to him. For example, Ya Jibalu awwibi ma'ahu. Mountains, sing along with him. When he makes the praise of Allah, the mountains would sing along with him. Wa tayr, and the birds too. But then he says, Wa alanna lahu al-hadid, ani'mal sabighatin, wa qaddir fi sird. He says, and then we made iron or metal, we made it soft for him. In other words, he learned how to melt and mold metal. And then Allah said, and then Allah instructed him directly, work on the armor and make the links in the chain and make sure they're properly calculated. In other words, Allah showed him the engineering for the kind of work he was going to do, the workmanship he was going to do with metal. Now all of these images about Dawood alayhi salam tie together. Going up into the mountains to find the materials he's going to use. And he sees the birds there that are singing the praises of Allah with him. And he brings those materials back, and he's burning those metals and fusing them and working on them, like, you know, an ironsmith, a worksman. These are the kind of people that have, you would think, even back in the days of a village, the lowest jobs. They're working with metals and burning them, it smells bad, you know, people don't want to be near them or around them, they're covered in smut, they're covered in this black dust that comes from the work that they do. That's the work they do all day, and it's not a job you do for 5 minutes or 10 minutes and you're done. You spend your waking day just working, 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 exhausting yourself physically. This is a very labor, you know, physical labor, blue-collar job, a factory job, you could say, that Dawood alayhi salam used to do. This is the example the Prophet gave alayhi salatu wasalam, and this is the example that Allah started with, that Allah gave this person a special favor, that He made him work like this. What I'm trying to get at is that by giving this example, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasalam has dignified through Allah Himself every job. When you are driving a taxi, when you're standing at a cash register, when you're delivering pizzas, when you're working as a janitor at the airport cleaning the bathrooms, when you're a security guard, there may be people around you say, what do you do? And you're embarrassed to say that's your job. You feel like, you know, oh, you have a degree, you're an accountant, you have an office, you're a programmer, you're a doctor, you're an engineer. Oh, I'm just a taxi driver. I just work at a grocery store. Oh, I just drive a truck, you know. You feel like you're less worthy because you do this kind of work. Allah Azza wa Jal honored all halal work. And He said, there's no better meal you can eat than the one you earn with your own hand. That's the way by which Allah dignified it. And He even gave the example of a prophet, alayhi salam, Dawood alayhi salam, that used to do physical labor. Another beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I was so inspired by this. Imma innahu kana in kana yas'a ala walidayhi aw ahadihima fahuwa fi sabilillah. If there's a person who makes efforts to provide for his parents, your parents have gotten old, they can't afford anything for themselves, you have to do extra overtime because your regular job, you have enough to pay for yourself. But now you have to support your parents too. Your parents got sick or they're old and now you need to support them too. So now all of your extra time is going into doing more work. So when someone makes these extra efforts to support both of their parents or even one of them, then what did the Prophet call it? فَهُوَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Then that is in the path of Allah. That person is struggling in the path of Allah. That's noble before Allah. You know, this person might feel bad. I don't get to come to the masjid as often as I'd like to. I don't get to recite Quran as much as I'd like to. I used to learn so much more, and I don't get to learn as much because I'm always working now, because I'm supporting my family. I feel like I'm giving all my time to dunya, and I used to give so much more time to Allah's deen. The Messenger of Allah comes to you and tells you, no, that is also fi sabilillah.